Yep.
It's all your fault, Ron Spears. What's up, family? What's going on? Welcome back to First Frequency of Oneness, Shock Metaphysics. I am your illustrious host, Rev Shock, Metaphysical Morpheus, Shockalicious, Shocktimus Prime, Shook Shocker, bald-headed dude with the crooked teeth. I'm back with our physicist, the man, the myth, the legend himself, and let me put him up on full screen here. Hold on. Where is he? There he is. Ron Spears. What's happening, my beloved? The physicist himself back again with another powerful presentation. And you are smack dab in the middle of a powerful webinar that is getting buzz and traction. And people are talking about it. And people's lives are being changed from it. Talk to us about it. How you been, brother?
Hotep Rev Shock, Hotep to the family. This has been great. You know, delivering the it's great times three. Number one, preparing the content is so much invigorating and fun to do because, you know, we've been rocking for a while now. So metaphysicists and the physicist. And so, you know, what else is there to share with the family that hasn't been shared already? Well, you know what? That made me go back to the drawing board and look at some and go deeper into Gagu, go deeper into the you know, the Nund Patah Atum, and do it from in my own special way from a physics standpoint, and then to blend in the metaphysicist. So that has been a lot more rewarding. And then of course the book itself. You know, Black Matter Lives. If you haven't gotten yours yet, you know, family, you need to.
You better get it. You better get it.
You better get this back.
Absolutely. For real, for real.
Go through the chapters in the book has been really, really good. And so that's number one is preparing for the webinars. Number two is delivering the webinars and getting the reaction from the participants has been just really, really, you know, that interaction because. You know, here, yes, we can read the comments in the chat and chop it up a little bit, but here we get to interact with some folks, and that's been really, really fun. So, it's been a great ride, and we just been warming up. It's about to get it's about to get even better.
Absolutely, I see B-Man, Reverend B-Man Ra is out there. What's going on, my beloved? Makaya Chauncey, I see you out there as well. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Everybody's coming on. Diafu or Diouf, Diaf. I don't know how to pronounce your name, but welcome. Welcome to the program. I've been really excited, man, about this webinar series. We're in, I think tonight is week, what is it, week three?
Three, yep.
Week three tonight of a four-part series. And it's okay if you didn't make it, you can always sign up, get the replays. And it's just as powerful. Of course, it's nothing like a live experience with the man himself where you can ask questions, but the power of this, of the content of this work. First of all, as you know, and I think most of the community knows, that's been rocking with me for a number of years. And it's been kind of crazy and an out of body experience for me because I sit up. This is my life and world. I just sit up in this chair. I had to get a new chair because my other one broke. I sit up in this recliner in front of this with a portable. Here it is. You can see it. I got a portable. I got my keyboard and mouse that's portable. I've got my camera, got my big screen, and I'm sitting here day in and day out, just knocking out content. And I don't get an opportunity to really meet and interact physically with anyone around the world. And so I'm always shocked when people, when I do connect with people, usually through one of our webinars or one of our promotions, and they say, hey man, I've been rocking with you for like, you know, 3 years. I've been rocking with you for 5 years. Dr. Marie Charles scared the hell out of me. She said, I've been watching you for 7 years. I'm like, what? So, so I say that to say, I've been in this game a long, long time. And obviously I've been in metaphysics even longer. Mm-hmm. After First of all, there is no one on earth like Dr. Gabriele Yibo. He's the one of a kind, first of his kind. When in 1990, when AMA gave him the GAGUD equation, the God Almighty Grand Unified Theorem equation, we as an African community in the diaspora, we've never seen anything like that. And when I started to do this deep research on what I call first frequency Africana phenomenology, the equation was solid. So I did, I think, 5 or 6 interviews or shows with Dr. Ayibo and Baba Kaba. Yeah. And so that was it. That was it in terms of the content. You know, many people, I think it's called OFAPIT or whatever his organization is called. He does some things on YouTube where he does some advanced teachings and training. But one of the things that we talked about was the fact that there's a strong accent. And so he doesn't come across where you can understand him as well. But also when he starts, because he is a, what is it called? There's a mathematical thing that he is. He has a, because he helped build the stealth bomber. He worked at the Pentagon. He's an aeronautics mathematician. That's what it is. When he starts to talk, at some point you get a glaze over your eyes. Yeah. So years later, here comes the physicist, and you and I start rocking. We talk, and you start talking about this concept called black matter lives. That fits perfectly with Gagunical understanding, first frequency understanding, Africana phenomenology, Afrocentricity, B1, whole nine. Great. Oh, you're phenomenal, Ron. And then when I said, hey, Ron, you need to write the book on this, and then you subsequently did, and then you did something that literally in my years, of at least in the last 10 years, no one has broken down Gagut better and more efficiently than you. Now I can say that not with this is not coming from a place of hubris. This is just coming from a place of I know everybody. I've interviewed everybody. I know all of the top metaphysicians. I even know the top physicists. I know Fred Allen Wolfe, who is a mega European in the physics world. None of these guys or gals our scholars have done what you've done. So I don't think the family really, well, I don't say they don't appreciate you, but I don't think they understand the significance of who you are in the game, in the diaspora, in the work of restoring us and being able to tap into that gagudical first frequency consciousness vibration. In the last couple of webinars, because tonight is webinar number 3, but in the first one when you did Gagut, that man, it was a university program, and I've never seen anything like it. When you broke down tensors and just really broke down each letter, each equation from a understanding it from a physics perspective, and then making it plain, speaking to us in a 6th grade level, because we ain't physicists or metaphysicists per se. You broke it down so we could actually understand it and then apply it. Bro, you're the GOAT. Seriously, you are the GOAT of Gaga. Not taking anything away from Dr. Ayibo, augmenting and enhancing his work and his life work. We need people like you, and also Brother Pi Ratio has done this as well. We need people like you to mathematicians, people who can break these complex things down and be able to bring it to us in a way that not only we understand, but we can use and activate real time in our lives. That's your GOAT. No one's done that. So I just want to give you your props and roses while you are above ground. Because a lot of times we just keep and hold on to that kind of stuff. So, yeah, I know Ron, he's badass. But if Ron don't know that, you know, Ron might be out here trying to, you know, do something else. He said, well, you know, you might start stripping as well and get you a shockalicious, a Ronalicious name. I don't want that to happen to you, is what I'm saying, you know. yeah, go travel abroad. I'm messing with you, Sean. So yeah, man, I just want to give you your props on that, man. Nobody has done what you've done. And I'm a scientist. I'm hardcore with this. I live this, breathe this day in, day out, 24/7. And I'm always looking for the right people, the right teachers, the right scholars, the right frequency to be able to bring that to the community, because there's a level of accountability that I have to have, because I can't do some of the stuff that some of us do, even some of the scholars and what have you do, that they get in and it's not what they signed up for, or worse, it was just a money grab situation and it was really no content or substance. So you're changing the game in that regard, my beloved.
Coming from you, and you know, I've seen the wealth of content that you've accumulated on your quest, both you know, both as a doctoral candidate in metaphysics, and as, you know, Rev Shock, who's been interviewing, like you said, everybody. And I've seen a lot of the diversity of content that you have accumulated over the years. And so, of course, the Acacia Records, you know, all the stuff, you've heard it all, both on a business
yes.
perspective, on a self-help perspective, and of course, on an Africa Sacred Science
sure.
Perspective. And so, you know, I just want to offer gratitude for you. And you know, it doesn't feed my ego, because I know where this knowledge comes from. But
absolutely,
you know, and that's where the gratitude, and again, in my stages of development with Kepra, the first step is gratitude. The mm-hmm. first step is the and the easiest step is gratitude. You just show gratitude for the blessings that you are giving, and the feedback and compliments that you've been given. And when you get to the point where you can show gratitude for the bad stuff that happens, because at some point it's going to be clear as to why that happened. But that's one thing I did with webinar two, because webinar one, you know, which was on God Almighty Grand Unified Theorem, I jumped right in. I didn't even introduce myself. Mm-hmm.
No, that's so true. That is so true. That is family. That is true. That is true. Yeah, you did. Right. He was so eager to get all of this research to the community, to the students. It was just kind of an assumption. We all knew it was Ron Spears. But if you didn't know him, and this was your first time signing up and meeting him, you didn't know who this dude was. You didn't know that he was a physicist at the end of that damn webinar. That's a fact. You knew this dude knew some shit, okay? But that was hilarious, because, again, but it was so much content. And it's one of those pieces of content where I have to say, even just with that first week or that first lesson on Gogget, for me personally, what it is and I think I can say this for the family. None of us want to miss anything. We don't want to miss the next big thing. We don't want to miss anything that's going to help us either, one, get out of the mess that we're in, or at least alleviate some of the pain for us to be able to navigate through what we're in. We don't want to miss that. And I have to say that if you don't have at least just... Now, all of the webinars, what Ron is doing is phenomenal, because week two was the bomb diggity as well on Sankofa. But if you don't have that first session, you don't know Gaga. You don't really know how to activate this thing. And it's just it was more than I had anticipated and expected as a metaphysician, because I did not know your PowerPoint. I didn't know what you were going to be presenting. I knew you would show up and come through, but I had no idea what you were going to do. Bro, I'm telling you. That's going to be the flagship product when it comes to anybody wants to know anything about Gogget, Sankofa, rites of passage. You're the dude, man. You have, that's the other thing, fam. This dude wrote a curriculum that is teachable to others. So if you want to learn how to train the trainer and how to make money and do and learn how to do rites of passage properly and have a guide, you're it. No one does what you do. And I think that's one of the things that is part of my brand, that I bring and find people that they're the only one in the world that does what they do. It's the same, you know, it's, we're in the same diaspora and dealing with, but there are certain people that just have certain skill sets, like yourself, a physicist, brother B-Man, who just called you the poetic priest. He, you know, his technology with the black room. Nobody in the world has this and does this. And that's what I think Clyde Winters was talking about the other day. But bro, you put your foot in it and you can tell you love your people. You know, I even probably pulled you to the side and said, man, I think you're giving away too much for the price that you're charging. You need to charge double the price for this kind of content. Shit. But you just love it and you give it to the family and we love you for it, bro.
Yeah, no, and you know, one of the differences with the webinar and then versus what we're doing now is it gives you a chance to just sit back and be a participant. I know
yes.
you're used to filibustering and talking.
Yep.
Your passion is deep. Passion and your mission, is deep. And I know you've been very transparent about why this is so important to you. And I receive that energy and that vibration from you and your transparency. And that's one of the reasons why, you know, it was really important for me to kind of circle back and introduce myself.
Go travel abroad. That's my girl Sean. She is out there, bro. I love her so much. All hail to the shock to the Shockalicious King. Long live Philippophile Kingdom. I'm not sure though. You know, the whole Philippophile, that might be a little bit much. I don't know. But I appreciate you, Goddess. I know what you're trying to say, and I appreciate you. Love you back. Go ahead, brother. Yeah, brother. Yeah, no,
that's why it was.
Do our brother Spears, especially his voice. Thank you, ancestors.
I get that absolutely. A lot.
You're loved, man. Like, you're loved, man.
I like they to love do you, my dude. Voice of God thing every now and then, but it really comes through in the audiobook version of Black Matter Lives, which you get with the webinar, and that's where you know that's where you really get the voice. Let's just call it that, but.
And the voice, and that's the other thing, you know, people hit me up all the time through digital nomics. And one of the problems some have is the understanding of a brand, understanding how to be unique. There is nobody else doing spoken word at the level that you're doing. Right. When I first got with you and you started talking about spoken word, I was like, I don't know about the spoken word thing. That's not my thing. But then when I heard it, and then I saw some of the videos that you produced with the house music. And oh man, that shit was dope. I was jamming. I knew at that point I was jamming my ass off because you're in Detroit. I was in Chicago. House music was one and the same. We were back and forth with it, right?
Yep.
So when I heard that spoken word piece and I talk about going into the black room with certain frequencies, certain sounds, like B-Man has his daily affirmations for both men and women. You have this spoken word that puts you into the nun. It puts you smack dab and gets you into the mood, into the mindset, and it helps stop distractions. What happens when you start to get quiet, you go into the black room, all kind of ish starts coming up in your head. When you listen to Ron Spears' poetry, that's your precipice to stop all the noise. And it's a gateway, it's an entry point into whatever your black room meditation is going to be.
Yeah, and that's part of the and one of the aspects of the book that I get into as part of the maybe the introduction was sort of my cosmic purpose, my life path number, which is the Master Builder 22. It's basically the metaphysics, the cosmic purpose, the ability to take metaphysical principles and translate into regular language that can transform lives. And I didn't make that up. That's just what I was designed to do. So I don't, when I was on with King Simon, because like Pi and Ma'at, King Simon does the numbers too, and he broke down my birth date, which is crazy, 6969, June 9th, 1960. It's love, 6 and 9, and then 69, is love, right?
Mm-hmm. And, of course, the Europeans took that and bastardized it, but that's another thing. We all know what they've done.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. And so, you can.
This is a science. It's a sacred science. Absolutely. But it's a sacred science. And honestly, only we can decode it. And decoding it, only we can benefit from it. That's the power of first frequency. Only we Africans in the diaspora can benefit from it.
And what we have to do to disrupt this signal is we have to elevate our consciousness into the noon. And then don't stop there. The patah is the spoken word. Okay. Right. The conversion of kinetic potential into kinetic energy. And that's where the vibration of the voice and the spoken word, especially when you mix it with the drum, the African drum, that creates the rhythm. And we all need a push. We all want to, we all want to go from 0 to 100 and basically be walking creators, atomic consciousness, in a in a day. And whatever I can do.
Not gonna happen.
Not gonna happen. And that's why it was important for me to kind of go back and because I'm not even there yet. Okay, I'm trying to get there too. But that's why I went back on webinar 2 and went into my background, because one of the most beautiful things that I'm proud of with my back, which I had nothing to do. I didn't pick who family and community I grew up in, but I grew up in an all black city, Detroit, an all black neighborhood, all black elementary school, middle school, high school, 99.
All black everything. Hi, Jay-Z.
All my black people, right? And I grew up in STEM, science, technology, engineering, and math. I grew up in STEM programs taught by black people. And so, I just have not been, until I went to graduate school, involved in any of the outside forces, so to speak, And so it's just been a beautiful thing that I have just been basically wrapped in my people. And so this didn't just happen overnight. And that's important for people to understand. And then all these gifts that I now, everybody talks about STEM, but the focus is on STEAM now, science, technology, engineering, the arts, and math. Mm-hmm. I make my living now writing, and with the voice and things like that. And so all that is art, the left brain and the right brain coming together towards that advancement. That's part of the process of becoming, which happens as you get older. In life. Absolutely. And so it's so important and relevant to just at least mention that and be transparent about that. This did not happen overnight, and you can't expect it.
A lot of people see the after. They see us on here doing our thing, and I think Reverend B-Man Rod talks about the he hit me to a concept he calls the LeBron effect. And because I'm from Chicago back in the day, it used to be the Mike effect. So we would see the Michael Jordan doing all of this amazing stuff on the court. And then on the weekend, we try to go out and do the same thing that Mike does. And we all end up in the hospital and shit, in emergency rooms, damn near having to intravenously use Bengay and all kind of ointments and shit, because our stuff is jacked up, trying to be like Mike, because Mike licked the LeBron effects. We make it look easy. Right. But this is not easy. It's an accumulation of years of experience and testing it. We know, we know what works. We know what doesn't work. We know what's basic. We know what's advanced. We know how to solve problems. And that's really what we're in the business to do. We're in the business to solve problems, but we make it look easy. It ain't easy, but most people want that immediate after, not understanding the before. You know how they use the term the overnight success. Well, they might have, you might know them now and just saw them now, but they've been doing what they've been doing for 25, 30 years. They're not overnight. Right. There's no such thing, right? So yeah, I totally get that, beloved. I totally
yeah,
get
that. Yeah. And you're then the right. And then with the participants on the webinar, you know, the brother Baba Bey, you see somebody with BEY on their last name, you already right. know what that's all about.
That's right.
Right? You know who you're dealing Facts. With. Right. Facts. And so, Facts. So yes, when I was at Morehouse,
that's a good point too.
We dealt with the Nubian Islamic Hebrews, the Hebrew Israelites, the five percenters, the nation. We dealt with the Black Baptist tradition, and we also dealt with the Moorish Science Temple. We just were
you brought all of that together under B1, under First Frequency, under Gaga Black Matter Lives. That was genius unto itself. Here's something else. When you mentioned Baba Bey, and shout out to Baba Bey, we'll be with him tonight. Baba Bey, I think is in his, I want to say in his 70s, maybe 80s. I'm not sure.
Doing yoga.
But doing comedic yoga. Facts, right? Let me say this too, because one of the biggest compliments you could ever be given, Brother Ron, is when one of our elders who's been in the game longer than we have and been alive longer than we have signs up for your stuff because they see a value, because they know they're going to learn something new because they already know every doggone thing because they've been exposed to it. That's why this is so important, because it's that next layer. Clyde Winters is another guy like that, but he always talks about this. Dr. Winters says this, that it's not about the scholars and the scholarship. It's about new information. That's why he's training us every Monday night in this 15-week research course. He wants new research to come out. 90% of the stuff that we're talking about that we do, the books are 30, 40, 50 years of age. And there's no new science being added to Africana phenomenology or Afrocentricity, humanities, metaphysics, and what have you. So the fact that you've got something new and you were able to attract an elder of that stature, that's also another amazing kudo. But a lot of people don't see that. That's why I'm saying it. So they can give you shout out. This is one of the things I learned from hanging out with Brother Andrew Muhammad and his team. They always say, put a one in the chat if you're feeling this right now. So put a one in the chat, family, if you are understanding that Ron Spears' Black Matter Lives is the Ijnit.
let me answer that question in the comments about Bey, B-E-Y. If somebody has B-E-Y at the end of their name, that means that they are associated with, in terms of how we come into the knowledge of ourselves, that we come through different routes, right? And the route that they come from is the Moorish Science Temple. You know, the Moors, I mean, you know the story of the Moors and what they did with Spain, migrating out of Africa into Spain, or not it's mm-hmm. not just Spain, but all of Europe for the most part. Mm-hmm. And the knowledge that
if I'm not brought. Mistaken, I think that's going to be Kaba's next book. I'm not sure. I know one is going to be on melanin and one is on the Moors. I don't know which one's coming first, but that's a big deal. Go ahead.
Yeah, so I mean, you know, it's just this paying homage to the Moore Science Temple and the Honorable Noble Drew Ali and the knowledge that that you know they have Not brought. Sure. And so the people who have it's just like showing and we'll do it with another elder that's part of our group, Justine. Last week was so special. She couldn't even barely get the words out. She was so appreciative of the knowledge. That she kind of, you know, was trying to get her words out. And I had the most wonderful conversation with her on Sunday.
Oh, wow. Awesome.
And we spoke for probably a good hour. And,
oh, wow.
And
nice.
By the end, she was just saying, alhamdulillah. And that she's she was kind of brought up in the nation, you know, of Islam. And she was trying to, I was asking her about, you know, when the Honorable Elijah Muhammad passed away, how, you know, she kind of went with his son, Warith Dean, and then now she's Sunni. And I was just engaged and just, she was happy to talk to me. And I'm like, this is what it's about, engaging with your elders. Facts. And she's, absolutely, you know, she's loving the knowledge and sharing it with her kids and grandkids. And she's about to soon have great grands. So, I mean, that it was just the most beautiful conversation. And I can tell that she was extraordinarily appreciative. So, I mean, that's phenomenal. At the end of the day, if you can't do that.
Right.
You haven't.
Why are you in the game? Why are you in the game? Right.
Your process of becoming is how you treat people.
That's exactly right.
People don't. People think it's all about the knowledge that you have. You know, I've taken kids to Africa, since the 90s. Mm-hmm. I'm about to take 12 Eagle Scouts to Africa in a couple of weeks. Mm-hmm. Okay. A life transforming event. That's how you rise. It's not just about knowledge.
Yeah.
It's about what you do with people and how you
treat. Absolutely. Absolutely. Now, I know you got a PowerPoint today. I know you got a PowerPoint presentation that you want to give to the community today, but I also failed to mention, you just mentioned it, and I forgot to mention it. And y'all can go out and test this for me. I don't think there's been anybody that's gone to Africa more than you. I mean, I'm serious. I'm just looking at how many times you have gone to Africa. Humanitarian, you know, Black Matter Lives work. And even some of our elders, our scholars, like Leonard Jeffries and Baba Smalls, you've been to Kemet, or not to Kemet, but you've been to Africa more than all of these people. Who the hell does that? So again, there's a connection. There is a vibration, a frequency. There's a level of code that you have that none of us have, and we can only access it through working with you and downloading your information and processing it. Because when we talk about African consciousness, bro, you are it. Nobody's done what you've done, and that's why you're so authentic in terms of social. There's a thing we teach in internet marketing and social media marketing. It's called social proof. Like when people just see you, a stranger, and they see your Facebook page or website or whatever content it is or whatever. Can it be proven? Are you just popular, or are you really a teacher? Are you just out here trolling or just out here ganking the community? Social proof is everything. What also is known as reputation marketing. You have the rep. You've got a rep, and it's amazing what you've done. So I know you're going to be doing some more training with us in a moment, but I just want, again, bro, you changed my life. You've changed the life of elders as well as everybody in between. That's a big deal because it's hard to move me. I ain't going to lie. I'm an asshole. Matter of fact, no, I take that back. I'm not an asshole. I'm a whole ass. I don't want to be just a small asshole. I'm the whole ass. And I don't mean to be that way, but I've just been out here too damn long. You know what I'm saying? I've been exposed to everything, to everybody. I don't come across as a know-it-all, but I have experienced a lot, and I just know the bullshit, and I know the people who are serious and the people who are not. And I know I've developed this ability to know exactly what the community needs, because I actually use myself as a guinea pig. If it works on me, based upon my history, my story, and what I've come through, and you know my history and story, if it works on me and for me, pretty much it's going to have a huge effect on the entire population of Africans in the diaspora. Whoever has gone through or is a descendant of the Maafa, you need to be on this Black Matter Lives wagon. It's amazing. And you're just getting started. You're just getting started. Just,
halfway through tonight. Tonight is going to be bananas. I'm just tonight is going to be. You're going to see tonight. You're going to see the culmination of all of this downtime from the pandemic when we were stuck up in the house. I was stuck up in the house in content creation mode. And tonight you're going to see.
I'm putting the PowerPoint up now.
And so,
that's fantastic.
Real quick, shout out to the elders. Shout out to the young people. You're going to see the young people tonight with what I'm doing for young people. But and so yes, you got to show love to the elders. You got to show love to the youth. But I see Greg West on one of the pivotal moments in my life is when I went to a prison and spoke to the brothers, not knowing how conscious they will be. And within right. minutes, I was breaking down Shikata Diop's two cradle theory, and they were throwing me questions, and we were just building, just like I was, you know, right back at Morehouse. It was a beautiful experience. So when you can show love to the people who are behind bars, as well as the absolutely. Elders and the young people, I mean, that's when you're really doing it. But
some of our most conscious people are some of our most conscious brothers and sisters are behind bars because, for one, they have nothing else to do but to become conscious, which is unfortunate that they had to lose their freedom to do so, because we know the system is at play and that they shouldn't be there, but they are. But many of them are not. They're not dying inside. They're still conscious. They're still doing the work and they're still growing. And shout out to you for being able to do that. And shout out to Greg West, because Greg has an organization called Fellows with a Future. And this dude literally transforms people's lives who come out of prison. It's the scariest thing in the world from all the research that I've done and all the people I've talked to. And where do you go? Well, Fellows with a Future, and what Greg does and what you also are doing is giving our Black kings their life back. And a purpose, a reason to live, skill sets. I think Greg even teaches like certain levels of like how to do manual, certain levels of labor where, you know, they right. literally come out after Fellows with a Future and they're working and they're employed. So shout out to you, Brother Greg, for what you do.
All right, so I just got a few slides tonight, a couple of teaser slides from webinars 1 and 2, Gagut and
all right, I'm going to put it full screen. Go ahead, brother. There you go. I'm muting my mic. Go ahead with the lesson.
So today's kind of lesson is about unity and manifestation, because like I said, at the end of the day, knowledge is great. Knowledge is power. But what do you do with it? And how can you manifest? And so that's kind of one of the key things that this webinar series is focusing on. Again, Black Matter lives. Love increases the vibration to disrupt the epigenetic signal. So, you know, that is what is there, to use the power of love. Now, here's, some people want to talk about the God particle. And this was part of the first webinar, is the discovery of the God particle, because obviously when you're talking about Gagut, what does the G stand for? The G could stand for God. The G could stand for geometry. The G can stand for, you know, anything else. But it really doesn't matter, because it's just a variable indicating direction, right? But when it comes to the God particle, the folks have not been able to prove things, because the speed of light cannot be replicated in a laboratory, where they built this multi-billion dollar particle accelerator somewhere, I think in Sweden, I believe. And so they are, you know, playing around with particles and they're bouncing.
It's 1 mile in circumference. Exactly. It's 1 mile in circumference. Did you hear me?
If you look at the aerial view,
they're looking for God. They can't find it. Ain't that a bitch? Go ahead.
All we gotta do is close our eyes. They gotta spend all this money.
They gotta build and it's $1 billion. How many billions?
Oh, several.
At least 3 billion. I think it's 3 billion. Some crazy number. Looking for God. All you gotta do is find a Black person and you see God. That's all. Okay, I'm moving on. Go ahead.
Just close our eyes. You don't need a physics degree. Just close your eyes and access the records. But anyway. I talk a little bit about the God particle in the first webinar, the Gagut. So sorry for the teaser, but you know, check out the webinar. Everybody talk about Black Lives Matter versus Black Matter Lives. Yes, you matter. Absolutely. Black Lives Matter, right? Until you multiply yourself times the speed of light squared, then you energy, right? It's because that's what we do, right? So Black Lives Matter, yes. Now let's close our eyes and do what we do, get in tune with our ancestors, and then become energy, right? Because that's what we can do. They can spend billions of dollars to try to replicate what we can do just by closing our eyes with being beautifully melanated people, with conscious of this power that we have in us. Right. So just again, as the final teaser, talking about tensors, when you look at the what a tensor is, no, I'm not ready. Y'all not ready for that one. The Gaugaud equation is based on a rank two tensor, right? And this is the I and the J in terms of its direction. And like I said, you see the letter C here. The letter doesn't matter. The letter, it just denotes a variable. But like I said, but when I was doing this research, I was like, a rank two tensor. Okay. You see one comma representing the transformation and the two different directions. Well, when you get into a rank three tensor and you bring in other variables or other directions, I was like, let me look at that a little bit deeper. And I'm not there yet, but here's a couple of interesting points. Because when you look at this, the way you in mathematical physics, you display the tensor in these four different areas, and there's four forces: the weak force, the electromagnetic force, the strong force, and the force of gravity. So that's another thing that the G could stand for, gravity, because it's how you're encompassing all of the forces, because gravity is the one thing that's a little bit different than the other three. And that's where, you know, Einstein and others could not complete the theory of everything, right? So I break down the theory of everything versus the grand unified theory. That's part of the webinar as well. So we have to talk about the four forces, and there's four areas here. And so when you look at some of the ancient Egyptian, you see what, four people here, and you look at this. What does that look like? Okay, in terms of power of creation, right? So I don't know. Coincidence, maybe. I don't know. But hey, check this out.
Well, it's amazing, because that's the Ankh, and that's it could be the fallopian tubes. It could be the reproductive system of men. The testicle. I mean, it's right there in front of us. We mastered this. We didn't bastardize it and sexualize it and weaponize it. It was a system and a way of living and being and honoring the as above, as below. Go ahead, my brother. You do it. You're on point.
And so, again, we look at the Shabaka stone, okay, and you see these four forces, and same with the Dogon and the twinness, okay, the Nun and the Nunet, matter and space, male and female, the Ha and Hahet, the infinity, male and female, the Ka and Kaket, the darkness and light, again, male and female, and the Amen and Amenet, the hidden and revealed, male and female. When you think about that, and what they did with the Shabaka stone, hey, is this all related? But I'm going to stop there, Rev Shock, because, you know, this is just a teaser. So anyway, if you missed it, get the webinar, get the replay, so we can break that down. But at the end of the day, we are walking creators. You don't need a degree in physics like I have. You just got to close your eyes and understand the G-I-J comma J equals zero, spirituality and obstacles, right? And then you go through that comma is the transformation. You go through the transformation, and then it's just the GJ, right? We know the spirituality. We know the obstacles, the equal and opposite reaction. And a lot of us can't get past that. We can't go through that transformation. But when you go through that transformation and you're at the GJ, that's the self-improvement. That's where God does not change. That's when God does not change, because the signal is disrupted and we can be our strong selves. The Nun, the Patah, the Atum is possible once you go through that transformation. We just got to get there. So that's that second webinar, the Sankofa experience. And that's where manifestation comes in, and unity, the Kepra, the spoken word vibrations that I'm sharing can help you in your process of becoming. And that's what I call self-transformation, as above, so below. That's the Gagu aspect of it, as well as the Sankofa experience. But you're not at the unity yet, because that's your self-transformation that's so important. The unity is when we have a collective transformation, the politics, economics, and culture with Africa, with the diaspora, and the signal frequency. You can connect with folks all over the world and really start to achieve, you know, and I was kind of serious, we can start creating some black holes and suck this, you know, anyway, we can make some real change happen. okay, once we start doing these event horizons, but that's a little too much physics there. The unity, the spoken word vibrations on love and marriage. You saw in that previous two slides ago about the importance of the male and female energy. If you're talking about the Dogon and the twinness, the mother principle, male, female energy. So that's webinar number four. The spoken word vibrations on love and marriage, and the spoken word vibrations on the reunification of male and female energy internally with us as men, and then externally with our African queens, because the signal disruption has destroyed Black male-female relationships. We've got to get that better. So if my spoken word can help celebrate love and marriage and help to repatch the issues that men are having with the feminine energy in us and the energy that we're having with our sisters, then if my spoken word vibrations can do that, then webinar number four next week is going to be the bomb. And then unity, of course, today's topic for webinar is African rites of passage for youth. Again, we got to bring up the youth and understand. That's why I'm so excited about this webinar series, because we have to start with self, and then we have to transform ourselves, get back to our African sacred science, transform ourselves, get back with our sisters, our queens, and build back Black love, so that we can have Black babies that are conscious. And anyway, you all get where I'm going. That's why unity is so important. Okay. And cause I take this very serious. That's an old picture of the physicist. Okay. I take this thing very serious, folks.
Who is that guy on the bottom, on the bottom photo with the beautiful bride? Who could that possibly be? He looks familiar. I'm not sure.
Yeah, I mean, you
beautiful Bill, lies, brother. Beautiful.
I think this was 27 years ago.
Oh wow, beautiful.
26, maybe, I don't know. 1996. That's when I got married. But anyway,
Can I mess with you a little bit, bro?
Go ahead.
The top photo, family. Does he not look like Al B. Shua? I'm just saying, you just look like Al B. Shua. I'm old as hell, so y'all can understand. Some of y'all. Put a one in the chat if the brother looks like Al B. Shua. That's all I'm saying. Go ahead, beloved. Go ahead. I had to mess with you because I love you.
Right.
Go ahead.
That's all right. You can do that. In traditional African culture, there is four stages of development: birth, rites of passage, marriage, and death. We get together for christenings when a child is born. We go to wedding ceremonies when you get married, and you go to funerals when our loved ones become ancestors. But we don't do anything in an African American culture to celebrate the passage into manhood and womanhood. And so the year that I went, took these young men to Africa, right, and got married, they were ushers in my wedding. So they got to see my next stage of development.
Wow, that's beautiful.
Have a vision of what is expected of them. That's how serious we take this thing, right? And this picture was taken back in the 90s, right? And so this is rites of passage. And tonight I'm going to talk about the rites of passage curriculum that I've used to train and teach these young men and women. And part of that is this the learning stage, the working stage, and the living stage, where we talk about the parents, our belief system, education, hobbies, peer pressure of sex, drugs, and violence. And then you get to that working stage where we're focusing on our career, getting married, having children, and the stress of those three over the course of a 30 to 40 year working stage can take its toll on our health, right? And then we have to prepare for the living stage to become an elder, where we're focusing on money. What are we doing now since we're no longer working? How are we earning our money? Since we're no longer working, what are we doing with our time? So lifestyle is important. And what legacy are we leaving behind? So it's very important to understand every aspect of life, right? And there's worksheets, there's discussions, and there's meditations, because the quantum entanglement of life is real for our people. And we are falling behind in a lot of these different areas. And we have to, it's hard for us to develop that level of becoming if we are really, really affected by any or all or many of these aspects of life. So my curriculum breaks down all of this stuff and exposes young people and adults to life skills. So that's why this is so important. And then some of the other things that I get into, I make sure that people know and understand what, how to develop a rites of passage program. That's a whole chapter dedicated that to that in the Black Matter Lives book, a whole chapter dedicated to that. But I introduce you to the gentleman who took us to his village. So you get to listen to me chop it up with him to talk about how this whole thing started. And then I talked to the people who, some of the people that you may have seen in that picture or some of the others I've taken in previous years, they're now, that was in the 90s. These are grown men now with families of their own. And I talked to them 20 years later about the significance of that trip and how it has shaped their lives now. Talk about evidence. That's what it's all about. And so the art of storytelling, the importance, you got to get, again, spoken word is everything. But I teach the art of storytelling, where I have a number of master storytellers sharing the art of the craft. And, you know, people like videos. They like to watch videos. But some people are into the podcast. Just listen. You know, it's beautiful. And Satori Shakur, she does the here in Detroit. She's the curator for the Secret Society of Twisted Storytellers. And so I spend time with her talking about the importance of storytelling and how to craft a great story, right? And then Oba William King, he's a master storyteller, doing things for young people. And it's just a way of story, the art of storytelling. And I share my story when I participated in the Secret Society of Twisted Storytellers. But the Black Panther Princess, oh my God. When I was at Morehouse, right across the street at Spelman, was Elaine Brown's daughter. Elaine Brown, the first female chairman of the Black Panther Party. Her daughter was at Spelman. And she's got a story to tell. She has sold her life rights to Disney, right? Okay. Because she's talking about growing up with Geronimo Pratt, because they lived communally. She didn't have, at Spelman, you know, for Founders Day, they wear those pretty white dresses. She didn't have any fancy shoes. She wore her white dress with black combat boots, because that's all she had. I mean, anyway, I tease it enough. There's just a lot of great content in this curriculum that can teach young people and adults the importance of storytelling. Right. And I talk about the mission work that I do in Africa. And the reason why we're taking these Eagle Scouts to Africa is because that's where the Boy Scouts and Girl Scouts of America came from. Lord Baden-Powell of Europe on a military assignment in Africa, observing rites of passage ritual. And from that, you know, as Europeans do, he created something and put their name on it. So the Boy Scouts and Girl Scouts have its origins in African rites of passage. So that's why we're taking a bunch of Eagle Scouts to the motherland in a couple of weeks. So again, there's just an example of what you're getting with my curriculum. Okay, and I take a lot of the videos because I'm all into content creation. And so a lot of the videos, people have short attention spans. So there's a lot of bite-sized chunks of these videos, 4-minute videos, a 2.5-minute video about me at Gory Island, a 3.5-minute video, my own 16-19 experience when I dropped my daughter off at Hampton University, which is in Virginia. And I was that close. Yeah, I went to the burial ground. Okay, anyway, you'll have to see that. And my videos on spirituality and things. Of course, the audio book, The Primordial Waters of Noon, The Sankofa Experience, The Love and Marriage. And so all of this spoken word and these content creations that I've done, I'm telling you, family, this can be life transforming. So again, love increases the vibration to disrupt the epigenetic signal. That's just sorry for the teaser, but you know, that is basically the type of content that is part of this webinar series. And I'm so excited to get this out to the family. And if there's anything that I can do to help push you through that transformation, then that's all that I'm trying to do. That's what it's all about. So
fantastic.
Few slides just to kind of recap what this webinar is all about, webinar series is all about.
Phenomenal, my beloved. Well, we are going to be there tonight with you, 5 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, 8 p.m. Eastern. Make it happen, family. You know what you're going to get. You know it's going to be transformational, not just informational. This is informational. What he's doing is transformational. So I appreciate you, bro. I'm looking forward to tonight.
Hey, I'll take a little bit of a break and come right back in. And then, you know, you're really going to see, you think I'm passionate now. Wait till you see tonight, because I spent a lot of time creating this curriculum content, because, you know, like I said, when you know this is what you're meant to do and you're designed to do, you just sit back and be like, God, this is all coming together. And so
absolutely,
I'm just super excited. Can't wait for tonight.
Fantastic, my beloved. Well, let's do this. So we get ready to set the tone for the family. Let's close out with our affirmation of power, if we may. All right, family, let's just take a moment for starting out this a wonderful week, this Monday, and in the frequency of first frequency, we simply say, I am one with first frequency.
I am one with first frequency.
I am one with the first thought idea.
I am one with the first thought idea.
I am one with the firstborn people.
I am one with the firstborn people.
I am one with the only one.
I am one with the only one.
Ashe.
Ashe.
And so it is.
And so it is.
Fantastic. Family, we'll see you tonight. See you tonight. Looking forward to it. Hotep community, Hotep brother Ron Spears, Uncle Job.